So for this episode of Vote, we're going to be speaking to Faye Bridgwater and Katie Sollohub. They're both artists and award winners. They've recently won an international award. So in this episode of Vote, we're going to speak to them and find out more. So I'm joined here today for this episode of The Vote with Faye Bridgwater and Katie Sollohub. And you're both winners of an art prize, both artists. Faye, should we start with you first? Just tell us about this art prize which you both won. And I know you don't yet know each other. We met for the first time on this interview. So Faye, tell us about the art prize first, maybe.
So it's the De Went Art Prize. And De Went are a pencil manufacturer. And it's a drawing prize. So you send your work in, and I think there was something like 5,000 entries this year. And we were both shortlisted. We both live in the area and we don't know each other. So it's really wonderful. Yeah, it's just been amazing that I got accepted of my picture of Brighton. So I'm thrilled.
And we're going to see that photo, I think. What was the inspiration behind that?
So my piece is all about the murmurations. I run a photographic group in Brighton called Brighton Skies on Facebook, and we've got nearly 14,000 members. And when the murmurations happen, we get thousands of photos and videos of these beautiful swirling shapes of the starlings between the two piers. And I wanted to capture it somehow. So I drew 140 squares, almost like when you're flicking through your phone, going through images quite quickly, and tried to capture the essence of a murmuration. So I kind of got my pencil and I stabbed the paper, trying to get the energy of a murmuration.
Yeah.
And Katie, tell us a bit about your artwork and a bit more about this prize and why you decided to enter it.
Yeah, so my artwork is a drawing of an interior space, and that's a lot of my work. It's about houses and being inside rooms, that kind of feeling of, especially empty rooms of old historic houses. I love that atmosphere. So that's what my work is about. Yeah. And I entered because this Derwent Prize is specifically about drawing. And quite often drawing is sort of seen as preparation for something else rather than in its own right. So I thought, fabulous, there's a prize for drawing. So I entered a charcoal drawing, really, really pleased to get selected. And then to find that I won the judges. So mine was selected from the shortlisted from 5,000 down to 70, from 70 down to one first prize winner, which was me. So that was just unbelievable. I only heard about it on social media. I didn't even think of the first prize. I didn't even know there was prize money involved.
Yeah. So Faye, just tell us a bit more about your work then. I know you live in the Brighton area. I think you've exhibited, or you're going to exhibit, artists open houses. How long have you been painting for? I mean, what's your kind of range of artwork?
I'd love to just say I'm a drawer or painter, but it's influenced by so many parts of my education and other artists along the way. So, but I moved to Brighton 10 years ago, and of course the children were small then, so I've probably gone back to painting for about 2 or 3 years now. And the subject of just living by the coast, I love it. I'm from Watford, there's no coastline there, no horizon to look at, so I think having this wonderful view out the window, being able to walk to the beach every day. I kind of like, when I was at university, it was sort of sneered upon, just painting pictures because something is beautiful, and it's a great joy now just to be able to paint and do whatever I want without anyone judging me. It's fantastic. Well, funnily enough, I did get judged, didn't I? But I'm just...
You were judged well, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if you find that, Katie, that you just love to draw now.
Yeah. I think it was my own sort of inner judgment that used to hold me back a lot more. And I think age and wisdom does give you a certain freedom to draw what you want. Yeah.
We can go into talk about lockdown and how that might inspire you a bit later, but Katie, maybe you, where do you find your inspiration? Because you're also on the coastline at the moment along Shoreham, so I'm guessing you're getting a lot of your inspiration from that area.
I'm not a landscape painter as such. Right. I remember at college kind of finding the outside a bit overwhelming, because where does it start and stop? And I remember quite consciously starting actually to work from still life, from things on the tabletop. And I did a lot of my college work about the still life, the tradition of the still life, and then I sort of stretched it and explored it. And from the still life, objects on your table, it became about, well, what's behind that? What's above that? What's up the ceiling? What's out the window? So it's really just an extension of one object into a room. And now, being in Shoreham, I think I am inspired by the sea, but it's part of my daily, it's part of my breathing, actually, is being by the sea. I swim every day, all year round, winter, summer. So that's one of my things. And I still think that's part of my art practice. That's part of my drive to get up out of bed, to kind of feel alive, regardless of what I'm painting. Although I have recently started a project about portraits of the people that I swim with. So that's something that has been quite different, to be doing portraits. Normally, as I say, my work sprang from the still life to the room, to the window. That was where it went. And I've started actually looking at people that I meet on a regular basis and talk to. And I'm doing portraits for the first time ever. So a bit like you, Faye, I just kind of, it's so nice to be free to go where you want rather than to be pigeonholed into a certain way of working.
Yeah. What materials do you use to work with, Katie? Is it, you paint, so you use charcoal for the everything, full range, yeah?
My sort of familiar, if people are familiar with my work, probably know me for quite expressive, large charcoal drawings. And that would be my first love, my go-to material in painting. It then extends into oil painting, and I go up to 9 foot tall. But then currently my work is this size, watercolours on my kitchen table. So it will go to anything. And I write, and I used to do performance art as well. So it stretches into all sorts of things. But primarily, drawing I always come back to, and that's usually charcoal drawing.
Yeah. Faye, how about you? About the materials you work with and your current inspirations. I know you spoke a lot about the Brighton seafront, but what else?
Again, I just... Well, my latest project was all going to be about White Hawk Hill and the Neolithic site there. But that's kind of come to a stop, unfortunately. But I was fascinated about, because I can see it from my home, and I was dropping the children off at school and going for a walk up there every day.
Yeah, I know very well.
I posted something on, I can't remember, Brighton Past, I think it was. Yeah. I wanted to do this project. And... somebody who set up the archaeological, there's a new exhibition at the museum, took me there, and it's just amazing what's up on that hill and how wonderful it is. So that was going to be my new project, but I've only got the photos and the videos so far, so I need to crack on and do some sketchbooks.
Yeah. So how you guys, do you do this as for a living then? You're both selling your artwork, is that right? And how's that been during the current coronavirus crisis, because I'm guessing you're selling stuff online anyway, so has there been much change or how's it for you? Maybe you, Faye first.
So I have made some sales actually, which was a surprise. I didn't know if anyone would be buying artwork at this time. I thought people might be quite cautious of their money, but yeah, I think because of winning the People's Choice for the Derwent Art Prize, I got a few sales after that, which was a real thrill actually, because they just pop up on your phone and you have to sort of double check, and yeah. So that was really wonderful. And I have got artwork in the window. There's a thing in Brighton happening, Open Windows 2020, and so I put work in the window, and I've had a few, you know, people asking me about it.
Katie?
Well, I haven't really been a commercial artist in the past. If I'd sell work, it's usually to do with a project, to do with a big exhibition. Maybe once every couple of years, I'll have a big exhibition and sell work that way. So I've been teaching for my living, and that has just stopped. and I've made, as it's almost, it's coincidental, the day I decided to tell my current students that I'm not teaching online and I'm going to concentrate on my work was the day before I won the Derwent Prize. So it was like this affirmation, confirmation that I was making the right choice. So actually I'm taking the opportunity through lockdown so I can now start showing people my other drawings, of which I have many. So I have it's kind of, if I take this time instead of teaching to actually get out there and sell my work, it could actually be really fruitful. Yeah, it could be the turning point.
So that's it for the first half. Join me for the second half. We're going to be speaking to Katie Sollohub and Faye Bridgwater much more about their artwork, the International Award, and about how they are surviving lockdown. Join us for the second half.
Remember, you can keep in touch with us on the various social media channels, Twitter and Facebook, by searching Latest TV. Plus, of course, you can see all our clips and get the latest news at our website, which is www.thelatest.co.uk.
So welcome back to The Vote. I am speaking to Katie Sollohub and Faye Bridgwater. They're both artists and award winners. In the first half, we spoke about their artwork and that award. We're now going to speak about life in lockdown and more about their paintings and drawings. Looking at artwork online, because a lot of the big galleries in London, they've put a lot of their artwork online because people can't see it at the moment. Well, obviously, we want to see work in person, but is it just as good to see it online? Or there's differences, isn't there? But it can be just as rewarding watching galleries online than actually being there. Is that right? And what are the differences there? Katie.
I would say it's never quite the same, I have to say. Yeah. I just think you've got to be there. But so like anything, like all the other things like music and theatre that are being offered, I think it's fantastic that you can get to see something you never normally go to. And I have drifted around a little bit around a few galleries, but it does usually leave me a little bit frustrated because I want to be there and see it. But then in that way, it might give me the incentive to seek it out at a later stage. So I think it does serve its purpose, and it's really exciting to be able to have access. But nothing will beat standing in front of the surface, the quality, the smell almost. You know, you really feel a painting or a drawing when you're with it.
Yeah. Faye, how about you?
Yeah, I mean, the children have been set things for their homework and they've really enjoyed like exploring Brighton Museum and things. But I'm the same, going to an exhibition, walking into that room, being immersed by the experience. The smell, as you were saying, is so important. It's not the same looking at a Bridget Riley painting on a screen to being in a room and it making you spin. I think that's what one of the things I'm missing the most is just nipping up to London and looking at an exhibition. It's when we will be able to do it again. It's kind of sad, isn't it?
Faye, maybe you first. You're going to be exploring lockdown, and what have you learnt from lockdown? Because I'm thinking artists, it's quite a solitary experience, isn't it? And you often want to be left alone anyway half the time to get on with the painting. So how's it changed for you?
Struggling, I've got to admit, I'm used to being on my own, radio on, having a coffee, and setting myself up for the day, painting and drawing. But I have two small children, and I haven't got the headspace at the moment. The one thing I am doing, actually, because I did study photography as well, I am doing a photographic diary. So every day I'm taking, it's for the children's future, actually. Every day, so I think I'm on day 55 now, taking 5 photos. Well, I take hundreds of photos a day, but I select 5. I edit it down to 5 photos a day of their experience of the lockdown. So hopefully it's kind of a historic document for us all to be able to look at in the future.
So what do those photos, because I've also been taking photos of around, But
their everyday lives.
Yes,
pouring a glass of milk, struggling with their homework, the house being a complete pigsty, or being out on the downs, running it all out. You know, I'm just trying to capture this little moment of, it's a normal life for them, isn't it? Then, you know, so hopefully they'll appreciate it, you know, in 10 years' time.
Yeah.
Katie, how about you? How have you been documenting it? So I think it's important to people to document this moment, because we'll be talking about this in years to come, won't we? The times we're living through.
Yeah. Well, I think it's interesting how important the everyday becomes, the smallest thing. So and my work, I was saying, I'm doing a series of little tiny watercolours this size about it's travels around my kitchen or travels around my home, and it's the everyday, but it's in watercolor. But it almost links to Faye's in some way, because I notice your work is quite often in these grids, and you're talking about the photograph. And because I've started recording these little moments, and then I do a painting over like my breakfast, for example. And then I take a photograph of the painting with the breakfast. So that's there as well. You've got the real thing and the painting of the thing. And then I post them on Instagram, as we do. And then you have this grid. And I've noticed that my work being square fits the grid. So it's like the whatever the process, that as an artist, that is the joy, that whatever you do out of necessity becomes really interesting. So I could just paint everything in my kitchen now and just rearrange it. I call it travelling fruit.
Yeah. I loved your picture of the stone the other day.
Thank you, Stone.
Yeah, I really love that. And it is about these tiny little moments of nothing, really. There's a lot of talk about dates of food in my house. I don't know about we've got to read that.
So
the fridge has become very important, hasn't it?
Yeah.
So a lot of people are struggling at the moment. They find isolation difficult, but obviously a lot of artists, a lot of writers don't find it difficult. So I guess it depends. Some people are comfortable with isolation, some people aren't. And it's interesting, isn't it? Because a lot of people thought they'd never have to stay at home for such a long period of time. And maybe it's people have reflected a lot more, haven't they? So have you got any comments on that, about, you know, this kind of need for reflection and people maybe reevaluating their lives? Maybe there are some kind of budding artists out there, and they'll now go on to become artists themselves or writers themselves.
Sure. I mean, my daughter, for example, is 12, and she's always shown a vague interest in art, but she's never done it as much as she has now. So if 12-year-olds can discover that that sort of peace and absorption through their concentration in their artwork, then that's fantastic. And I think there is that opportunity to find peace. I think sometimes we're stretched a little bit to do a Zoom yoga class here and a something else online there, but actually it's about finding inner resources. And I've found that it's not always easy, but this has given me the opportunity to explore that a lot deeper. So I can be on my own in the studio for the first time in years, because I was always out to work.
Yeah.
So,
Okay, Faye, any follow-up on that?
Yeah, I think people are... It's interesting, the Zoom meetings, I think the children just have had enough of them, really.
Yeah.
And... today, I've got one of my photos from today. It's just them sitting on Dottie's bed, just colouring in. And they did that for about an hour. And he's just taking time out, isn't it? And just colouring in something or doing a jigsaw puzzle. This slow way of life that we probably all talk about before lockdown. And now it's being forced upon us. And possibly this is a good thing to learn how to be bored.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Before we go then, Katie and Faye, how can we look at your artwork? Have you guys got websites, or where do we need to go? We're going to show some, we've been showing some of it during the programme, but where else can we go? Maybe Katie, you first.
I'm on Instagram as my name, Katie Sollohub, and Facebook. But also I do have a website. Again, it's the same name, katiesollohub.co.uk.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Faye, over to you.
So, yeah, I'm on Instagram and it's Faye, F-A-Y-E, _Bridgwater, without an E in the middle. I've got a website, same spelling, FayeBridgwater.com. And, of course, I'm on Facebook as well. So, yeah. And Pinterest. Love it all.
And just a word for Artists Open Houses. They do great work. I guess you guys at some point will be exhibiting at Artists Open House. I know it does... It's gone beyond Brighton now. I know there's some in Lewes, Katie. So are we going to see it in Shoreham as well? I think there are already, but...
Yeah, the Ada Art Trail is normally on in Shoreham, but I think that will be postponed to next year. Yeah. But I am showing at Glyndebourne, part of their festival. That's online this year.
Perfect. Okay, Faye, last word to you then.
Yeah, so if Artists Open Houses do take part later in the year, I'll definitely be in that. And I've also got some work in, hopefully if it takes part, in Art Wave over in Lewes.
Perfect. Okay, we'll leave it there. Katie, Faye, thanks for talking to us though. Congratulations again on the award, and we'll catch up again soon. All the best.
Thank you. Really nice to meet you, Faye, as well.
Happy to meet you in real life. Wow. Yeah. Weird.
Yeah. Thanks, guys. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed that episode of The Vote. We heard a lot more about Katie Sollohub and Faye Bridgwater, their work, their art, as well as life in lockdown. So join me again for the next episode of The Vote next time. Thank you.
Remember, you can keep in touch with us on the various social media channels, Twitter and Facebook, by searching Latest TV. Plus, of course, you can see all our clips and get the latest news at our website, which is www.thelatest.co.uk.